In November of 1994, while he was in the prison, he was at the work detail. He and another man named Jesse Anderson were assigned to clean up lockers in the gym. Christopher Scarver, a man whom my office had convicted of murder a number of years earlier, was on the same work detail. He took the barbell from the exercise room and bludgeoned Dahmer over the head with that weapon.
The information I received from the prison was he did not resist the attack.
The irony in all of this is that the first time that Mr. Dahmer killed was when he picked up some weightlifting equipment and took the life of Stephen Hicks. The whole thing came full cycle.
I think he was in general population within a year when he was killed. It was surprising that Dahmer had lived that long.
Dahmer's father, Lionel, joins us now. Tell me, you told me that you were at work when your wife first called to say that your son had been injured, and then what happened after that?
Well, she had called and hit me with the news that Jeff had passed away that morning about 10 o'clock. I just couldn't believe it. I started sobbing and shaking.
I was very upset. You can't help but to become close to somebody when you spend that many days, weeks, months with them.
Some suspected that the prison system had deliberately undertaken to execute Dahmer. And the governor very wisely immediately ordered a commission to investigate it.
This prison has nearly three dozen video monitors, electronic steel doors. Yet somehow 25-year-old Christopher Scarver allegedly managed to elude the elaborate security system.
One went to answer a phone call, another was listening to radio music. It was ridiculous. No one was around.
I used to work in prison. We watched them bathe. We watched them eat and sleep. We watched them pee and poop. Anytime they moved, we were there.
Dahmer was probably one of the most celebrated prisoners in the Western Hemisphere. How is it that so prominent a prisoner could be executed in the prison? There was a study, and the commission looked at it and said, no, there was no crime involved, that there was no conspiracy, no inside job to get rid of Dahmer.
They have given him good but fair care. They've guarded him. They knew the potential dangers. It's not the prison's fault. Jeff, for all that he was a killer, could never defend himself.
I could not celebrate when he was killed. I can understand why some might, but I felt nothing but sadness. A sad story with a sad ending.